everyone. Good morning. Today I'm going to be reading you a story called Morris Micklewhite and the Tangerine Dress. Morris Micklewhite has a mother named Mora and a cat named Moo. Morris likes Sundays because his mother makes him pancakes on Sundays. Mondays are great too because on Mondays, Morris goes to school. Morris likes lots of things about school. He likes to paint. He likes to do puzzles. He likes the apple juice at snack time and sing the loudest during circle time. Most of all, Morris likes the dress-up center and the tangerine dress. Morris likes the color of the dress. It reminds him of tigers, the sun, and his mother's hair. He likes the noises the dress makes. Swish, swish, swish when he walks, and crinkle, crinkle, crinkle when he sits down. He takes turns wearing all the different shoes, but his most favorite goes on, click, click, click across the floor. Sometimes the boys make fun of Morris. Sometimes the girls do too. Morris pretends he can't hear their words over the swish, swish, swishes, crinkle, crinkle, crinkles, and click, click, clicks he makes when he walks. Morris pretends he can't hear their words. But he can. On Monday, Becky tried to pull the dress right off his back. You can't wear it. You're a boy. On Tuesday, Eli, Henry, and the other boys wouldn't let Morris ride on their spaceship unless he took the dress off. Astronauts don't wear dresses. On Wednesday, Bea and Lila noticed Morris's fingernails. His mother had painted them for him the night before. They chased him around the playground chanting, pinky fingers, pinky fingers. On Thursdays, the boys wouldn't sit near Morris at the snack table. We don't want you to turn us into girls. On Friday, Morris pretended he had a tummy ache. When he thought of all the kids in his class and all the mean things they did and said, his tummy ached for real. His mother let him stay in bed and read books about elephants. Moo sat in his lap. Moo liked elephants too. On Saturday, Morris's mother brought him some apple juice. As he took a sip, she stroked his hair. Moo purred loudly. Morris suddenly felt well enough to do a puzzle. He hummed to himself and felt better still. On Sunday, Morris crawled out from under the covers after a wonderful dream about being on a space safari with Moo. In the dream, they saw big blue elephants and tigers, the color of the sun that Morris could hold in the palm of his hand. The elephants swish, swish, swished as they moved through the grass, and the tigers are giant leaves that crinkle, crinkled as their tiny teeth chewed them. The buttons on the spaceship click, click, clicked under Morris's fingers. Morris wanted to share all the amazing things he had seen. He took out his brushes, put on his smock, and began to paint, using every color he could imagine. He showed his paintings to his mother when he was done. He pointed out the big blue elephant, the tiny tiger, the color of the sun, the tall grass and the giant leaves. He pointed out Moo in his shiny round space helmet. And who's that? His mother asked, pointing to the little boy in the tangerine dress riding atop the big blue elephant. Morris was hoping she'd ask. That's me, he said. On Monday, Morris went to school with his painting rolled up in his backpack. Then, when he had the chance, he put on the dress that reminded him of tigers and the sun and his mother's hair. Morris swish, swish, swish. The tangerine dress crinkle, crinkle, crinkled. His shoes click, click, clicked. Morris felt wonderful. Eli and Henry wouldn't let him on their spaceship. So Morris built his own. He hung his painting on the front of it and climbed in, ready to take off. Are there really elephants in space? Eli asked. And tigers? If you follow me, we can find out, Morris offered. Eli and Henry followed Morris to a planet they had never visited before. As they explored, Morris swish, swish, swished, the tangerine dress crinkle, crinkle, crinkled, and his shoes click, click, clicked. By the time they returned to Earth, Eli and Henry had decided that it didn't matter if astronauts wore dresses or not. The best astronauts were the ones who knew where all the good adventures were hiding. Morris smiled. He already knew that. When snack time was over, Becky demanded the dress. Morris told her she could have it when he was done with it. Boys don't wear dresses, Becky snipped. Morris smiled as he swished, crinkled, and clicked back to his spaceship. This boy does. I love that story. And you know why I love that story so much? It's because it's about being who you are. There's no such thing as what boys should do and girls should do. We can all do whatever we love and find joy in life. If you want to wear a dress, you wear a dress. If you want to be an astronaut, you be an astronaut. If you want to paint your nails, you paint your nails. We are all different and unique, and that's what makes us special. And we should never make somebody feel bad about who they are. If you don't understand something, you can always ask. You know, his friends, instead of saying, you can't play with me because you're a boy and you wear a dress, they could ask him, I've never seen a boy wear a dress before. Why do you wear that dress? And Morris could explain to him how it makes him, it makes him feel when he wears it. He feels like he can do anything. It makes him feel happy. And maybe that's why, and then maybe his friends would have understood that. So this is a really nice story because it has a really nice message. And I want you guys to know that you can be anything you want to be, and you can wear anything you want to wear. And no matter what, serendipity, your parents, your friends, we're all going to love you. And that's what's amazing and special about you. And I think that's what's special about Morris too. Okay, guys, I'll see you another time. Bye.